Our last kind of biomolecule are the lipids, and this includes the fats, the phospholipids, and steroids. The structure is a little bit different for these guys. They don't have a true monomer. They don't have a set repeating unit, but they do have defining R groups. And so the different kinds of lipids are defined by some kind of attached group. The true fats and oils have a glycerol or more attached to their particular backbone. The phospholipids, as you might guess, have a phosphate group attached to them. And steroids are made of a series of rings all put together. And you may look at this and think, wow, these are all very different. Why are they all lumped together in a group? And it's because of these two characteristics. First, they have a high number of carbon-hydrogen bonds. And second, they're all hydrophobic. So again, if we do some Latin roots, hydro means water, phobic is fear. So all of these guys are nonpolar and they don't interact well with water. Remember, water is a polar molecule. It's got that positive side and negative side. So all of these different kinds of lipids are going to try and stay away from water. And we're going to spend more time on phospholipids when we get to cell membranes. What you think about in your everyday food in terms of lipids are the true fats and oils. And you guys know water and oil doesn't mix. That's because of this hydrophobic nature. Functions vary along with the different types. So true fats and oils are mainly for long-term energy storage. If you burn 1 gram of sugar over an open fire, it's going to produce 4 calories. If you take the same amount of fat, it's going to produce 9 calories. And what that tells you is that fat is just a more efficient way of storing energy. You can pack more energy into a smaller space. And I know we all have interesting relationships with fat and fat on our bodies, but biologically, fat is a really great and efficient way to store extra energy. Phospholipids, these are going to be important in the cell membrane and they're going to act as gatekeepers. So you need a cell membrane that can let some things in and out, and phospholipids are going to be able to do that. Finally, steroids, including cholesterol, are going to help regulate different kinds of body functions and help the cell membrane stay not too liquid and not too solid. And we'll talk more about cholesterol when we get to cell membranes and steroids when we talk about the endocrine system. So we have these four biomolecules that are absolutely essential for life, and we just spent a little bit of time explaining what their structure was, what their functions are, what their monomers are. I found a nice way to review is to make your own blank table and try and fill it out and see what you remember from this. Here's an example. You can list the macromolecules. What is its monomer? What is its structure? What is its function? And what are some examples? And this can create a really nice table that you can use for review.